Hello everyone and welcome to episode 10 of Daily Flip. I'm going to be giving you a look into what my day was like today. It was a fairly easy day. I actually didn't really start working until lunchtime today. If you see me looking down, it's because we're also live inside of our Facebook group. If you're not a member, why aren't you a member? We'll put a link down below where you can join that group. It's absolutely free. We would love to have you there. We have almost 3,000 people there. I actually had a really cool post today. I'm going to go read it. For those of you actually watching inside of the Facebook group right now, you probably have already seen this. I'm gonna go over to my computer. I asked a question today inside of the Facebook group, and what it read was, for those that have flipped a few cars, what would be your best one piece of advice for those just starting? And as of 30 minutes ago, I haven't refreshed this. If our camera can even show that on my computer, we've got, I don't know, a good 10 responses. So if you are new to flipping, it'd be a great place for you to go read the answers to that question. We have Mitch here that says, buy all the PT Cruisers you can get your hands on. Don't listen to Mitch. I actually commented there needs to be a sarcasm font on that one. PT Cruisers are the worst possible thing you could possibly buy. Mitch knows that. He's just trying to have a little fun. But I'm gonna walk outside, give you a look at what I was doing. For those of you, again, on Facebook Live, feel free to post any questions that you have. I will come back to it. It's dark right now, so this is not going to be the best lighting whatsoever. Actually, I probably should turn my lights on outside. One, for security, and then two, maybe we'll be able to see a little better. The reason I didn't come in until around lunchtime today is because I actually spoke at my son's school this morning. They have chapel every Wednesday. So I was in there, and I'm actually gonna walk over to this light. I speak once a month for them, so that was a lot of fun. And then I came in this morning, and, well, I say morning, around 10 o'clock, my wife came in, her phone was buzzed, it just wasn't working, so we went to the Apple store, ended up doing Konki Japanese at Crabtree Valley Mall here in Raleigh. Really good Japanese, so by the time we finished with that, I wasn't back till after lunch, so kind of took it a little bit easy, but what we did get accomplished was we got our Saturn Outlook we may have mentioned yesterday. I'll walk over here, even though it's dark. We'll take a look at it. We had a CV joint and a water pump we had to put on it. The gasket was bad for the water pump, and the CV joint was just clicking. You get a click of noise when you turn left or right. A lot of times it's your CV joint. This is our Saturn Outlook. This is a Jaguar here we had painted. I think I looked at yesterday in our video. Had this painted at Mako. It is ready to roll. It's on the front line. So we now have 6 vehicles, which is not a ton. Normally 10 to 15 is what I like to have, but I only have 6 right now. We've got, engine needs to be ordered for our Jeep, we've mentioned. Catalytic converter's coming for this. Our pickup truck was really big this morning. I've been driving this 2004 GMC Sierra so that the readiness monitors would reset. I mentioned that yesterday and why we had to have them to reset. It is, I'm gonna hold my camera up right over there. Out by the road. It did reset. It did pass emissions inspection, so now I gotta detail that. We have to put a blower motor resistor. If you ever have a vehicle that only, the blower motor only works on the highest setting or just one setting, a lot of times it's that blower motor resistor. Basically what it does is it limits the power to the motor. So on full blast, it's giving it all the power. When you have it on setting number 3, it's giving it, you know, roughly 60% of the power. So that's bad, gotta fix that. Maybe a couple other small things and it's good to go. What else did we do? I think I showed yesterday. I'll show you guys again just because I'm really bummed about it. For those of you maybe that are watching today but didn't watch yesterday, I've gotten up with my body guy. He tells me he can fix, luckily there's a light back here. He says he can fix my Jeep Liberty, that we have the rust issues in our windshield, but this is what we have. If you can see that, we've got a hole here, we've got a hole here. When we pulled this windshield out, there's no glass in here. This is what we found, so he's gonna have to actually cut that out, put in new metal, and then put some fiberglass over it. This will have to come off here, and then we'll have our windshield mounted in. The paint will be taken care of. This vehicle will be good to go. Otherwise, we did some diag on this vehicle here. This is actually a customer's car. Bought it from us. Beautiful car. 2008 Chevrolet Impala. Wrecked it once, brought it in. His driver door wasn't open. I helped him get the door open. Then he wrecked it again here. actually hit something so hard he bent his engine cradle. He actually cracked the transmission, bent all kinds of stuff up underneath it. So we put a transmission in it for him, actually had someone put it in for him. We replaced the engine cradle, we did all kinds of stuff. And then he had a little issue. He never came in, never came in, never came in. Apparently he hit something else, cracked the transmission again. And so now he's driven it to a point where he's ruined this transmission. This guy is just, anyway, he's if he'd just come in, everything would have probably been covered under warranty. He's waited way too long, trying to help this guy out. Actually, in the meantime, he's been in another accident. You can see that in the back. I hate it for the guy, but he obviously is not the best driver. This is one, hopefully this week we get a master cylinder on it. Otherwise, we've been working towards, I keep mentioning our podcast, we're really excited about that. It's just a lot of wires on my desk right now. I think I showed that yesterday. I think next week I will be able to it sounds stupid, but a headshot taken. I have to have a picture for the podcast. If you are familiar with podcast, you know that when you click on a podcast, there's a picture, like a little square picture. So we need one of those. So I need a picture of my face. So I hate having pictures taken, but I'm gonna go. A friend of mine has a setup with lights and all that good stuff. So we're gonna be doing that. For those of you on Facebook, our video just crashed, but I think we're back up. If you have any questions, throw them in. That's really it. Only had a half day today. I'm gonna sit down because this camera setup's getting really heavy. Oh, that's much better. So if you're not subscribed to this page, definitely do so, because if you ever have any questions whatsoever that I can answer in any of these videos, you'll be the first to see the videos because it's gonna let you know that they're live. You can definitely post questions in any of these, whether you're on Facebook, whether you are on YouTube, if you're seeing this at thecarflip.com, we would love to have any questions. It's me, I have a computer guy that helps me, but I'm the one coming behind and answering all the questions. Other than that, tomorrow being Thursday, let's see, nothing really big going on tomorrow. A lot more prep stuff. We're shooting for the course tomorrow, some reconditioning videos. We shot one today on cleaning carpet. We shot one on touch-up paint today. We shot some, for those of you inside the course, you'll be seeing them coming. We shot some more template videos inside of our car flipping course, thecarflipcourse.com, if you wanna get more information about that. We shot some videos basically of cars that I'm doing. The biggest questions that I get are people asking, you know, what car should I buy? Or how much should I pay for this? How much should I pay for that? The best thing that I thought I could do was show you what I'm flipping. So a portion of the cars that I'm flipping, we're actually taking videos of and showing you exactly what I paid for them, what I had to do to them, and what my potential profit's gonna be. So that's basically what I expect to sell it for, minus what I paid for it, minus all the expenses, which I'm listing out. So that's something I'm really excited about. We got two more of those. We got one on a 2009 Volkswagen Routan. I think I'm pronouncing that right. It's if you actually search that out, it's actually just a Chrysler Town & Country. Volkswagen actually contracted with them. Chrysler built it for them. Then we did one on a 2008 Jeep Wrangler. When I got in, that actually needs an engine. So we kind of go through the mindset of buying a vehicle with an engine that needs replaced. So we've got that one. We've got one tomorrow. We'll be filming on a 2010 Saturn Outlook. We'll be going over my cost. Just as an example, I'm gonna run over these numbers in my head. This 2010 Outlook has 170,000 miles. It might be 172,000 miles. I paid $2,900. I had to put a $48 CV joint in it, and that's what sends the power from the transmission. And something just fell over in the corner. That was really scary because I'm in here by myself. So basically I had to put a $48 part. That's what gives the power from the transmission to your wheel. We had to put a water pump on it. The water pump was like $40 on Amazon. All in all, I'm gonna have with labor, my mechanics on site, but I'll have $3,300. We'll find out tomorrow when I tally it up. So say $3,300. This vehicle will sell easily for $5,500. Even though it has the miles, it's really nice. I mean, it's leather, backup camera, it's tax time right now. So that's, my profit's gonna be over $2,000, and I'm gonna break that down into bite-sized pieces for people inside the course so that they could then copy that, or they could find similar vehicles in that price range and know roughly what kind of profit they could expect and know where they needed to be and just know the mindset behind, you know, I bought it with issues, but they weren't major issues, and what to avoid, those type of things. So I'm really excited about that. Otherwise, I am about to head out. It is, if you can look at the clock up there, almost 7 o'clock here Eastern Standard Time. So I am rolling out, I have to leave by 7. So hopefully I have time to upload this video, get it on YouTube, Facebook, all those places. We'll put links to all those places down below. If you're not, you know, following us wherever, we would love to see you there, love to see you anywhere and answer or help you in any way that we can. Otherwise, I will see you guys in the next video. Danny, saw you at the last minute. Good to see you. We are closing out. I'll see you guys in episode number 11.